Wicca and Tarot Bundle. The starter kit for modern witches to learn herbal, candle, and crystal magic traditions. Discover real tarot card meanings, simple spreads, and exercises for seamless readings. Written by Sybil Wolfe. Narrated by Sybil Wolfe. Tarot for Beginners. The ultimate guide to real tarot card meanings, simple spreads, and intuitive exercises for seamless readings. Learn symbolism, history, secrets, intuition, and divination. Written by Sybil Wolfe. Narrated by Sybil Wolfe. Introduction. This little tome is the last book you'll ever need to read on the tarot. Yes, really. The tarot, a simple deck of cards emblazoned with occult symbols, promises to reveal what is hidden. We consult the cards in search of answers, a glimpse of what's to come in our lives. Each arcane image holds a message for us. Should we be aware enough to recognize it and wise enough to heed it? And having picked up this book, you are well on your way to both wisdom and vision in spades. If you have ever wanted to practice tarot but felt intimidated by its complexities, if you have seen evidence of your own psychic abilities and long to unlock your intuition and dive deeper into these powers of yours, if what has always stopped you from mastering tarot is the drudge of memorization, then this book is for you. I have practiced tarot for more than 20 years and worked as a professional card reader. In my years of building a relationship with the deck, there have been many ups and downs, trials and tribulations, struggles and breakthroughs. I wrote this book because I feel called to share with you the simple truths about the tarot that I have learned through experience, to give you the keys you need to unlock tarot mastery without struggling as I did. In these pages, I've passed to you everything I know about giving an effective and authentic tarot reading in clear language, busting a number of myths you may have heard along the way. If you follow along with me, you'll learn how to recognize the symbolic images in the cards and use these clues to feed your intuition. You'll practice trusting your gut when interpreting the cards so that you never have to memorize another card's meaning again. And when you stop reaching for the guidebook, insightful, powerful readings will flow naturally. I've pulled a card for you, dear reader. It is the High Priestess. She has much to teach you if you follow her into the depths of your own consciousness. So, come along with us. Chapter 1. Demystifying the Tarot. Of the many methods of divination, the tarot is perhaps the most quintessential and the most misunderstood. The cards are often featured in popular culture, typically in the hands of an antagonistic witch or gypsy, feared and respected for her clairvoyant powers. She pulls death from her deck, and the protagonist gasps in horror. With their ornate, symbolic artwork and promise of the future revealed, the cards fascinate and terrify in equal measure. In recent years, public opinion of tarot has shifted. What was once considered heretical black magic is regarded more and more as a means for spiritual growth. Even still, the truth of the tarot remains obscured, intentionally, oftentimes, by tarot practitioners, and it is from this sense of the unknown that fear springs. The essential first step in learning to read the cards is understanding what they are and how they work. So let's pull back the shroud. Tarot 101. The tarot is a deck of 78 cards, four suits of 14 cards, analogous to the suits of today's familiar playing cards, and 22 trump cards. When used for divinatory purposes, the cards are shuffled, chosen, and arranged in what practitioners call a spread. A tarot reader then interprets or reads the cards in the spread based on their relative positions and arcane imagery. The goal is to divine guidance, and commonly, a specific question is asked of the deck. Tarot can be practiced solo or with a group of querents, those who are seeking guidance, and done anywhere with minimal tools. The practitioner doesn't even need to be in the same room as the querent. Video calls work great for readings. While some readers prefer to write their observations down in private and deliver them to the querent that way. The key to card reading. Anyone can learn to read tarot cards and read them well. All it takes is a little bit of study and a lot of intuition. Intuition is key. It is the entire mechanism by which the practice of divinatory interpretation works. Intuition is the ability to understand something without conscious reasoning. It is the voice in your head that is sometimes hard to hear over the din of life, the sensation in your gut when you know something is true, but you can't explain why. Everyone has the power of intuitive knowledge. It is innate to your humanity. Learning to harness this power and growing your intuitive abilities is what makes a great tarot reader. When you read a tarot card spread, it is absolutely essential that you listen to what your gut tells you about the meaning of the reading. If instead you lean entirely on the written card meanings, your reading will be flat, lifeless, and probably nonsensical. The tarot doesn't reveal truths to you so much as you reveal truths by the way you intuitively interpret the cards. This seemingly subtle distinction is everything. The power of divination comes from within you, not from the tarot deck. We'll cover all you need to know about tapping into your intuition in this book. What you stand to gain. Unlocking your intuition and learning to read the cards will benefit you in many ways. Here are just a few of the things a tarot practice can bring to your life. Clarity and decisiveness. Tarot cards excel at helping us make difficult decisions, not because they provide clear instruction, but because they help us see the situation clearly for what it is. New perspectives. You will likely intuit messages from the cards that challenge your way of seeing things, or you may have ideas you never would have considered without their guidance. Improved relationships. When it comes to relationships, romantic, friendly, familial, or professional, the cards can help you find compassion for others and empower you to communicate your needs and feelings. Confidence and self-love. Building your intuitive power will naturally build your confidence as you learn to trust yourself. Living your best life. The tarot can help you not only identify patterns in your life, but find the root cause of them so that you can break them for good. With regular practice, you'll start to realize your highest self. Comfort in hard times. You can turn to your tarot deck when your mind is clouded with troubled feelings. The practice itself is meditative and calming, and the guidance you'll find in the cards can bolster your resilience. And inner peace. Stick with your practice, and you'll cultivate a sense of deep spiritual calm. Tarot myths busted. I can't read tarot cards because I'm not a psychic. This belief is as widespread as it is patently false. Tarot, much like divination, is an intuitive practice, and while it may come naturally to some, using your intuition is ultimately a learned skill, not an inborn talent. My aim with this book is to give you everything you need to tap into and embolden your inner voice, the one and only way to deliver authentic, intuitive tarot readings. Tarot cards are magical objects imbued with power.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.